Hello and welcome to this new video. So today I'll quickly show you how to upgrade Meshtastic, in this case for the Heltec V3, starting from firmware version 2.5, and as you see here on the right, we'll get to version 2.6. So the upgrade will preserve most configuration, because even by backing up the existing configuration, some of it will not be restored. That is what I noticed. So this procedure involves only the terminal, so the command line. Here I am on Debian. And so the first thing you need to do is to install Meshtastic and ESP tool. We'll do it in a Python virtual environment, since they are all Python packages. Okay, now I created the virtual environment. And now we'll install Meshtastic and ESP tool. Okay, now the virtual environment is ready. And here, if you notice, I already downloaded the firmware files. So in this case, we're using the firmware ESP32 files, which you can find, of course, on GitHub. So what I did is to download the correct zip file, which for the Heltec V3 is ESP32S3. It's going to be this one. So you can download the zip and unzip it like I did here. But first, we need to back up the system configuration of your board. So the first thing you need to do is to enable Bluetooth and check if it's working, because I tried with the several boards before and the Wi-Fi configuration doesn't get restored automatically as expected. So if you want to have a working environment after the upgrade, I think it's better to set up Bluetooth, a working Bluetooth with your mobile phone, so you're sure it's going to work later. And this is the first step, which I'm not going to show, but you can do it from the app. And then from the command line, you need to dump the configuration, which I ran the command here before, so it's very easy. Meshtastic export config, and then you redirect the output to a YAML file like this. So of course my Heltec V3 is connected via USB. So this is the configuration. Here I redacted the sensitive information. Anyway, but Bluetooth, you need to have enabled true. While for the Wi-Fi, because the Heltec V3 has a Wi-Fi interface, it needs to be disabled. So in this case, it's not even, see, you can see it here, there's no information if it's enabled or disabled. So in theory, it should be disabled like this. So now we can close the file and do the firmware upgrade. So we'll go into the directory, firmware ESP32. And you can see here on the right, there are two commands, one for the install I don't need to use anymore because I already have Meshtastic on my board, and the other one is for the update, which is the one we're going to use now. And I'm not using the web option, so to have the web interface, which is something new. I think it wasn't present in version 2.5, but it's available in version 2.6 because I'm using a self-hosted client, the official Meshtastic client, so standalone, I mean, in a Docker container. Anyway, to do the upgrade, device update -F, firmware Heltec V3 2.6.4, update.bin should be sufficient. Okay, now it's doing its job. Chip is ESP32-S3. Of course, remember just to plug in one device at a time or to specify the device, otherwise you risk flashing the wrong device. Now it's going to take a while and we'll come back when it's finished. Okay, now it took like a couple of minutes. You see here, 105 seconds, so it's not that long. It reset the board and now we can perform the restore. I need to restore like this. It's all written here in the Meshtastic, in the official Meshtastic documentation. So now we're going to do this. Okay, yeah, now it's doing okay. So now the device should be upgraded and the configuration should be imported correctly. Now I'll check on my mobile phone if it's working as expected. Okay, so there are other things to do. which I forgot. So the first one is you need to reset the region. And of course, I always advise to backup your channel before starting the upgrade, just in case. And you should also double check the settings, because as I said, some of the settings are not restored. And I noticed that the modem preset, for example, went to the default long fast, where here in Italy, most of us are using the medium fast. So you need to fix that once you restore. And about the channels, as I said, the simplest thing to do would be to do a screenshot of the QR code containing all the channels, and then once you upgrade your firmware, you just take a picture using the Meshtastic phone app, and it will repopulate the correct channels like that. So that's how you do it. I hope this video was useful, and here it's on the Meshtastic website. It's assumed that everything is going to work right away, but it's still not the case. So, and if you find the video useful, put a thumbs up and subscribe. And as always, bye bye.